Hey, what's up, DIYers? Mike Boers with the Mike Boers channel. Thank you for watching. We're talking tub faucet handles. And in the event that you've tried everything to tighten your handles, but they still come loose over time, maybe a week or a month, we're gonna show you a little trick. Let's take a look.
All right, DIYers, inside the bathroom now. Here are our handles, and this is the hot one. See how wiggly and loose that is? In the event that we don't tighten it once a month, that handle falls right off and into the tub. That's not cool at all. So most videos will show you, well, take that cap off, access the screw. In most cases, it is a Phillips screw. Go ahead and tighten it, and you're good to go. However, in the event that you do that, and it still continues to loose over time, we're going to show you a quick little hack that is pretty clever, clean, and won't cause any damage to your internal screw and thread. Getting in the tub, positioning myself, and I've got this little drain plug here. I don't want to drop anything, put that over the drain. I've got a very fine flat head screw tip, and I'm going to carefully insert it in the cap here. And each cap should have a little gap or slot. See it right there? Find it on your cap, carefully push your cap out, and set that in a safe location. And inside there is your Phillips screw again. You can tighten it. However, if it comes loose over time, that can get pretty annoying. So we will change to a Phillips screw bit and remove that screw. Phillips screwdriver in hand, carefully insert it and go ahead and remove that Phillips screw. And it's all loosened up. Go ahead and carefully pull your knob off. And again, your screw is right inside there. Let's go ahead and tip the knob up. And there's your screw. In front of me now is the handle we pulled off. And in the event that you have your old handle with the screws that you pulled off to replace with these, you may get away with just using the old screws to secure that handle to the cartridge or stem. However, if you try that, that doesn't work. We're gonna grab this screw and some Teflon tape. In my hand now is just some Teflon tape I purchased from my local Lowe's. And let's go ahead and wrap that Teflon tape, one wrap around the thread of that screw. And there is a right way to do this, and there is a wrong way. And what I mean by that is how you apply and wrap this around the screw. We want to wrap the Teflon tape around the screw in the same direction as the screw will turn to be tightened. Because if we did it the opposite way, we will run into the Teflon tape peeling off the thread as we tighten the screw, and that would not be good. So again, apply it properly. Real quick, I changed camera angles to show you. We have the head of the screw at the top, and we are wrapping it clockwise around the screw. And I cut 1-inch pieces of Teflon tape, and that lower Teflon tape will be for the screw inside the cold handle. Back to the screw, and just work that Teflon tape into the thread and do your best to make it clean. Try not to be sloppy and bunch up the Teflon tape. And again, you don't want to use too much. You just want about 1 inch of Teflon tape to wrap around those threads. And the first screw is complete. From here, what I will do is screw the screw in and secure that handle. And again, applying that Teflon tape in the manner we did will allow the Teflon tape to tighten with the turn as opposed to loosen. Grab your handle and carefully just drop your screw in and wiggle it until it falls through the hole. Carefully align this on the cartridge or stem and screw it tight. With the screw properly aligned without cross-threading it, go ahead and screw the screw in and secure your handle. Be very careful as you do this. Do not cross-thread it and do not over-tighten it. You want it pretty snug, but again, do not over-tighten it. Set the screwdriver down, grab your cap, and it is in the fully closed position. From here, align the H properly and carefully press it in place. Some will click, some won't, and hopefully that helps alleviate that screw from coming loose on a regular basis. All we'll do now is remove the cold handle, wrap the screw with that 1-inch Teflon tape we've got already cut, and reinsert the screw and secure that handle. Hopefully this helps, DIYers. Hey, do us a favor below the video. You will see that thumbs up icon. Click on that, like the video, subscribe to the channel. Definitely ring your YouTube bell. That would be very helpful to us. We would really appreciate it. Thanks again for watching. And one more thing, scrolling above is a link to a video where we install this cool little splash guard, because what we were running into was during showers, water would run down the seam where the tile meets the tub, because the tub itself unfortunately is not level, and water would fall off the edge of the tub and down onto the floor. We wanted to fix that without spending a boatload of money and having to lift the tub itself. So again, that splash guard is pretty cool and it works great.